r/AskReddit. Insomniacs and troubled sleepers of Reddit. When you wake up at 3 a.m. and can't fall back asleep, what do you do? I do a reset. If I can't get back to sleep, I get up and walk through my bedtime routine again and then get back into bed. It usually works. Sounds like a good idea, but my bedtime routine is just to go to bed. I used to have insomnia in middle school, and having a set bedtime routine really helped with convincing my brain that it was indeed time to go to sleep. Before that, I would just put my PJs on, turn off the light and go to sleep. I simply wallow in misery. Thank you for asking. Same here. I lay there annoyed that I'm not asleep and then start thinking about all my personal failings until I fall back asleep half an hour before the alarm. I get up for the day. I've had some days where I'm running on half an hour of sleep. It truly sucks, but I don't know what else to do. If I just lay there, I never actually fall back asleep and usually end up getting out of bed a few hours later. Consider seeing a sleep doctor/therapist. Saved my life. I usually listen to a podcast rather than look at anything on my phone. I find that the light from the screen only makes it less likely that I'll be able to fall asleep again. Edit. Thank you so much for the awards. Really looking forward to trying all the suggested shows. That's me right now. I usually browse Reddit for a while or watch YouTube until I get sleepy again. Sometimes it gets really bad and you just lay there. Then the sun comes up and the birds start singing and all you can think is, duck. I'm there, right now. I'm breaking my rules by being on Reddit, but here you go. Fellow insomniacs. 1. Do not get on your phone. Turn on the TV, or turn the lights on if your intent is to go back to sleep. You're just going to duck up your brain. 2. Lay still. Close your eyes, and start with the letter A. Name 5 things from a category that start with A. Baby names. City names. Items in a grocery store. Types of animals. Things you would find in an office. Whatever. Name 5 things from that category that start with the letter A. Then move on to the letter B. Then C. And so on. I skip Q and X. 3. If you make it through to Z, move on to another category. I've been trying this the past few weeks and rarely get through a few letters before falling asleep. This is my new go-to. I do this until my intrusive thoughts get in the way. Masturbate. Fun fact. This actually works for men. Not sure about women. But masturbating debilitates the mind enough to get you hoozy and may even help with falling back to sleep. It's a proven stress and even pain reliever. So it ultimately comforts you enough to help with sleep. Came here for this comment. I'm wondering why it's so low. This was my first thought before I thought some more. Still the same thought after hahaha. Do the washing up quietly so I don't disturb my man. Go outside and look at the sky. Empty the rubbish bins quietly. Snuggle my cats. Get lots of licks and headbutts in return. Snuggle my hippopotamus stuffy named Earl and try and find a position where my body doesn't hurt due to my chronic illness. Worry about everything I have said or done in my 40 years on earth. Try and go back to bed. Snuggle my man. Wake him up. Stroke his back until he falls asleep again. Take my cats back downstairs and snuggle them again. Cry. My body hurts so much and I have to get up for work in 3 hours. Put on a comforting, familiar film or TV show like Harry Potter or B99 with the volume down super low. Try and listen only and cover my face with a pillow to reduce the stimulation to my brain so I forget I am worrying about everything I have ever said or done and focus on reciting the dialogue in my head. Fall asleep hugging my cats and Earl. Wake up 1 hour before my alarm is meant to go off. Rinse. Repeat. I'm sorry to hear about your chronic pain, but I may be able to offer advice when it comes to the part where you said you think about everything you've ever said and done. I used to not sleep because of this kind of anxiety too until my therapist taught me a surprisingly simple but effective mantra. I just sit or lay comfortably and repeat phrases like I deserve peace and rest, I cannot change the past, and I cannot do anything about it at this very moment and stuff like that, while also following a specific breathing pattern. It helps me tremendously when the gears start turning a bit too much. Edit. Spelling. I meditate until I fall back asleep. Plus I remove the extra drape to get myself colder as I read somewhere that being colder makes it easier to fall asleep. Exactly why I sleep with the ceiling fan on. But it will take away your oxygen :0. Lie there for hours and feel like shit in the morning. Occasionally take a shower. I can't even fall asleep until 5 a.m. on most days, and then I'll just watch the sun come up and debate if I should nap or get up and try to fall asleep earlier later on to reset my schedule. Rarely works. You just described me. Right now, it is 5:14 a.m. Here's to sleep for the both of us. 3:18 here and sitting on my couch with the gin waiting to feel even remotely tired. I think it'll get a bit better when the quarantine finally ends and life goes back to some normalcy. Stay safe and sane out there, and sleep well if you can. Get up and wander around, trying to figure out why I'm not asleep. Do I need to pee? Am I too hot cold? Do I need some water? If I drink the water, will I need to pee again? I hear an owl. It sounds so close. If I go to the window, will I see it? OMG. It's right there. Watch the owl for a while. Get into bed. Realize that my back hurts. Maybe that's why I'm awake. Try to go back to sleep. Since I'm already back in bed, it's not happening. Get up for some painkillers. Try to pee again just in case. Since I just drank another glass of water, get back into bed. Every anxiety I've ever had crowds into my head. Listen jealously to my husband's untroubled slumber. Get out my iPad and earbuds to watch something to distract my brain. Doze off for an hour or two to Blue Planet. Wake up tired. If by what do? You meant how do I go back to sleep right away when this happens to me? Then sorry. I can't help you. LOL. I lay there for an hour or two before driving off again usually as my alarm goes off at 4:35 a.m. My current time I seem to be waking up around is 2:34 a.m. The last several nights that's the magic time. I'm hoping as we get into winter, I'm in Australia, the cooler nights will help me sleep more. I would get up and start the day. But once I'm up the dogs want to get up. Then I'd end up waking everyone else. I hate insomnia. I wish I could get more than 4 hours sleep at night. But even more so I hate that my 17 years old is already showing similar signs of sleep deprivation and insomnia and not even her sleep meds are working effectively now. Surf Reddit. Damn. I have not read or heard surf in that context in a long ass time. Feels like the 90s. Weed. Sometimes this keeps my mind busy even more and I can't sleep. I started using Headspace app. It has a specific nightcast thing for when you wake up, to help you fall back to sleep. Currently I try that, and if that doesn't work, I just put on a series and pretend to watch it. Used to clean my room when this happened. It happens less now that I am medicated so nicely. Read a book. Do some work or study. If I've got a few extra hours in the day, may as well be productive. Also might put me back to sleep. I'm a night owl or vampire or whatever they call it nowadays. I can't sleep until sunlight and it's really annoying when I have a job. Thankfully the pandemic took that from me. Now I just plug up my headphones and play COD or whatnot all night and sleep all day. To wake up at 3 a.m. I would have had to go to sleep before 3 a.m. I feel like I would have had to have gone to sleep before 3 a.m. is the proper grammar, but it's 7 a.m. and I still haven't slept, so I can't tell if that's actually just a nonsense sentence. Put the office on and drift off to sleep, only to be woken every 20 minutes by the absurdly loud opening credits. Before marriage, I would jerk off until I was tired enough to fall back asleep. Being married, I have to tiptoe to a secondary room or bathroom and jerk off silently like a ninja. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.